The ants are very tiny insects, but their colonies can possibly grow in large numbers with millions of workers on some species. But from the millions of ants existing in a given colony, only a single ant is important over everyone else, the queen. She is the founder of the colony and responsible for laying thousands of eggs a day in mature colonies. Her existence is vital to ensure that the colony won't die out, or simply saying that the death of the queen would definitely mean the end of the colony. That's why she is well guarded by workers to prevent predators from killing her. But what happens to the colony when the queen dies? Can they still thrive? Is there a way to save the left members of the colony if their queen dies out? In this video, we will try to merge two colonies of the same species of Camponotus because of some unfortunate news, so stay tuned and observe what will happen to both colonies. Can we be successful on merging them, or will it result to a tremendous war? Today, I will check the progress of my two Camponotus colonies. At the same time, I'll feed them to support their growing numbers. But upon seeing the first test tube, I wondered why the workers and their brood were stuck at the end of their setup. I'm also thinking about their queen. Was she left alone on the other side of their nest? Anyway, let's check it out. These workers were acting so strangely while I was pulling the test tube cover. Is their queen okay? Then I saw the dead queen with the worker around her. What happened to their majesty? I have no idea about possible reasons. Did I make the mistake raising them? Upon observing, it seems like there is some bad microorganism on their queen. That's why the members of the colony decided to isolate themselves from the queen. We all know that the Camponotus colony is a monogenous species, as they only tolerate one queen per colony. But I will try if this type of Camponotus can be adapted to a new colony of the same species to continue their function as workers. This is my second colony of the same species. The queen has two workers with a few brood. Merging ants from different species or even the same species is very risky because they can kill each other. But I hope that this type of Camponotus can adapt ants from different colony. As you can see, a colony with a dead queen seems depressed and hopeless of continuing their colony. But we will observe their gestures if they can adapt to another colony. I connected the tubes. And one worker was exploring the other test tube until she met another worker from another colony. Wait, are they performing anaphylaxis? The other workers were walking around the unfamiliar location. Look at this worker! She was moving so fast, like giving an alarm to another members of the colony. At the moment, there's no aggression observed from the two colonies. But we'll observe for another minute. Suddenly, something negative came into my mind. Are the workers attacking the unfamiliar queen? But no, it was like they were happy to find a new queen that they would have to serve for the rest of their lives. And the queen wanted some food from the workers. I think they're compatible with each other. So I decided to cover the test tube for them to transfer the brood to the other side. But one moment, the queen suddenly visited the other setup. Does she need to check the brood that she will adopt from now on? After some time, she went to the dead queen. It's like she was giving a signal that she would adopt her left workers and brood. Way back last year, these queens were given by a friend, Alano from La Union. They were in a similar container, but I separated them to each other to form their colony. So I was wondering if she can still remember her roommates and felt some sadness to see her dead amiga. After some time, the queen went back to her original home. So I'm expecting the workers to get the adapted brood to the queen's nest. One moment, I discovered that there was nothing left in the living queen's nest. And afterwards, look what happened. The living queen migrates to the nest of the dead queen. This is so bad. After some days, they finally finish moving out from the dirty setup they want. I think the colony was already settled in the new nest. I am glad that I successfully merged the two colonies. I am hoping for the fast development of this colony since they have adopted some brood and workers. So, thank you guys for watching. Hoping to see you at the next one.